Hello everyone. My name is Luisa, and the project I'm going to present to you today is my master's thesis, with which I just graduated this year from ECAL. And like so many of my fellow colleagues at university, I wanted to create a project that deals with sustainability, but instead of just focusing on the way that we might consume a product or produce one, I sort of wanted to go all the way to the source and actually create a sustainable material myself. And it all started when I came across a company based in Germany that produces this fiber called C-cell. And C-cell is a cellulose fiber made from eucalyptus wood pulp and brown algae extracts. And it's produced using an innovative and closed-loop production method where all the water and solvents that are being used are constantly recovered and hardly any waste is generated. And apart from its eco-friendly production method, the C-cell fiber has a set of other very unique properties. It's fully biodegradable and compostable. It's 50 times more absorbent than cotton, quick dry, breathable, and thanks to the algae that's permanently embedded within the fiber structure, it's also inherently skin-caring and antibacterial. And despite these amazing material properties, the fiber is actually only available in fabric form blended with other fibers, such as cotton, and its application is limited to sportswear and loungewear fashion. Luckily, having been supplied with a fairly large amount of this fiber to experiment with, I had the idea of why not just create a pure version of this C-cell fabric myself. Well, after weeks of unsuccessful emails and phone calls, it turns out that this is actually much easier said than done. And I was quite naive and I had no idea how time, energy and resource consuming the production of textiles actually really is. And I had almost given up when I luckily came across the DITF, which is Europe's largest fiber and textile research institute based in Germany. And they were incredibly helpful and really, really motivated to work with me on this project. So I packed my 25 kilos of fiber and I traveled to Stuttgart, where the institute's pilot manufacturing site is located. And there we processed the fibers, we cleaned them, we created a first batch of pure C-cell yarn, which we then wove into the very first batch of 100% C-cell fabric. Here you can see the five steps of the textile production from the unprocessed raw fiber all the way to our finished fabric. And the fabric we created is incredibly soft and whilst being quite durable and sturdy. I also experimented dyeing the fabrics, which turned out to be quite easy thanks to the material's hydrophilic properties, which means that it's very attracted to water. So when it in the end came to finding a suitable end-use application for this fabric, having a background in furniture design myself, my first ideas all revolved around maybe upholstering a sofa with it or creating a natural mattress. But I really felt that none of these applications were actually making use of what this material is really good at. So after diving into much broader subject matters and also focusing on the three key elements of this material. So the crazy water absorbency, the antibacterial character, and the softness of it, I eventually arrived at what I believe is the best possible application for my material. It's baby diapers. So every child spends their first 3 to 4 years of their life going through approximately 5 diapers a day, which adds up to a total of 5,000 diapers in those first 3 to 4 years. In Europe alone, there are 5 million children born every year, where 80% of all parents only use disposable diapers. Which, if you do the math, means that 17 million diapers a day end up in landfills and dump sites all across Europe. And due to their material composition, a single disposable diaper takes up to 500 years to decompose, which also means that the very first diaper, which was invented in the 1950s, is still with us somewhere, rotting away in a landfill. And not only are disposable diapers pretty harmful to the environment, they're also quite harmful to the little humans. The so-called superabsorbent polymers, which are the chemicals that make a disposable diaper work, of course, absorb all the pee and the poo, but eventually they also end up absorbing all of the moisture from the baby's skin, which leads to diaper rash, painful skin conditions, and more recently there have even been cases of cancer linked to the toxins that are found in disposable diapers. The market for more sustainable alternatives is growing. More and more parents across the world have started switching to using cloth diapers instead, not only due to the ecological reasons I just outlined, but also in the long run, it's actually a lot more affordable for parents to use cloth diapers. Not being a parent myself, at this stage, I had to sort of immerse myself in the whole world of cloth diapering. It's a very complex system, actually. And also, I had to meet and familiarize myself with the subject matter. So I met parents and their babies. And at this stage, I came up with my design objective for this project, which was to limit the materials found in a cloth diaper and actually design a 100% monomaterial one using the C-cell fabric I had created. One of the first very challenging aspects I came across was actually to find a way to waterproof the C-cell material in an ecological safe way. Here, I ended up partnering with the Swiss brand Schoeller and ended up using a material called EcoRepel. EcoRepel is a waterproofing agent that is biodegradable. It does not need to be re-impregnated, and it's actually designed to withstand frequent machine washings. A second challenge was to find a replacement for the elastic band that is always found in cloth diapers. And after prototyping various ideas, I ended up using another material innovation called natural stretch, which is actually a way of knitting fabrics in order for them to have up to 20% natural elasticity without using any elastan or any polyester. And thirdly, I had to find a way to securely fasten the diaper around the baby's body without using any metal or plastic buttons, no Velcro tape. And here I ended up designing the diaper in a way that it has fabric straps that you can simply tie around the baby's body. This not only allowed me to stay 100% monomaterial, but in the end it actually turned out to be the most flexible way of diapering a baby. And this is how the final design looks like. The Sumo diaper is made from 100% skin caring and sustainable sea cell fabric. At home it can be simply placed in the washing machine and washed. The design comes in three different sizes. The smallest size is for newborns. The second size is for babies between 6 and 20 months. And the largest size is for toddlers. And alongside the diaper, I have also designed a diaper bag, a wash bag, made entirely out of 100% sea cell material. It has a small front pocket where we can store small fresh diapers, and a larger outside waterproof pocket with a roll top so that parents can temporarily store and seal away dirty diapers. This project, of course, has a very special place in my heart due to obvious reasons. But I think also as an industrial designer, you don't often have the opportunity to actually design and invent the main ingredient of a project yourself. So I feel very lucky that I was allowed to, that I could go through this journey. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.